So I wanted to touch on the topic of the thyroid gland, but specifically a goiter. What is a goiter? A goiter is an enlarged thyroid gland. You have this little gland in the brain called the pituitary. It makes a hormone called thyroid-stimulating hormone, which then connects to the thyroid gland. Two main purposes of the thyroid-stimulating hormone. Number one, it tells the thyroid to release T4 and T3 to some degree, but it also has another purpose, to increase the size of the thyroid gland. So if there's too much of this hormone, that could be one reason why it's enlarged. And one of the big reasons for a goiter would be an iodine deficiency. In fact, 90% of the time, it's going to be an iodine deficiency, not 100%, 90%. And realize most of the time, it's going to be benign. It's not going to be a malignant tumor. Now, this condition mostly is associated with a hypothyroid gland, but sometimes it could be associated with a hyperthyroid gland. So you have to be able to think with all the information, because if you have an enlarged thyroid and you have symptoms of a hyper, your eyes are bulging out, you have a high pulse rate, fast metabolism, you're sweating, you can't sleep, versus hypo, which is you're sluggish, you're losing your hair, you're depressed, you're gaining weight, then that would be more over here. Okay, so if you have hypo, of course, you'd want to take iodine. If you have hyper, you don't want to take iodine. There's several reasons why a person might be deficient in iodine. One could be they just don't get it in their diet because they're not consuming shellfish or seaweed or sea kelp or eggs, for example. But it could also be they're exposed to bromide. Bromide is used as a conditioner in dough or flour when they're making bread. That could be one reason. There's other ways that you could be exposed to bromide, but bromide will deplete iodine. Also, fluoride. Unless you have a good filter at your house, you're probably getting fluoride. That can deplete your iodine too. Number three, I already talked about this. Number four, pregnancy. It's very important if a woman is pregnant or lactating that they're taking some trace minerals, specifically iodine, because if that child is born with iodine deficiency, they can have hearing problems, even become deaf, and they can also have mental deficiencies as well. So iodine is very, very important in the formation of the brain. Smoking can cause a deficiency of iodine. Alcohol can create a deficiency, and low selenium. Now, when someone has a goiter and they get tested, they may find that their T3 is a little bit higher than it should be. Now, that's weird. You would think that would be low, but what's happening is the body is trying to convert as much as it can to compensate. So you might have higher T3 and lower T4. All right, that's my summary of the goiter. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.